Welcome to part 7, the final part of our guide on how to paint the contents of the Warhammer Age of Sigmar box set. Now in this part we're going to be focusing on Corgus Cole, the Mighty Lord of Khorne, who is of course the General of the Chaos Army and so deserves special attention. So we're going to be covering everything to paint the entire miniature, so things like the armour, the bone, the metallics, also the fantastically detailed cloak and of course the demonic skin on the flesh hound. So let's grab our brushes and get started. Before we start painting anything, I just want to quickly point out to you that I've actually assembled this model as two separate sub-assemblies. This is to make the painting process easier because, well, I'll be able to easily get to certain details on the parts. So I've got the Lord as one assembly, and I've got the Flesh Hound as another. And I've glued the Flesh Hound onto a spare flying stand that I can use to hold it whilst I'm painting. And this is going to be very useful, especially when I'm putting shade on it. If you decide to do the same thing, then I recommend you stick the Flesh Hound to the flying stand using super glue to make it easy to break it off once you're done. Now the first colour that we're going to use is Khorne Red, and as always make sure the lid's fully closed and you give the paint a good shake before you use each colour. And this is, well, for almost all of the Flesh Hound to begin with, but also is going to be a part on the Lord as well. Now I'm going to be using my large base brush to apply this because I'm going to be putting on so much, and as always I'm going to use my palette to put some paint on there. Then I'm going to add some water to it, don't need loads, but just enough that it thins the paint down so that it will dry nice and smooth once you've finished. So I get that mixed together nicely like that. Make sure I don't have loads of paint on the brush because you don't need loads at once. And I'm going to start on the hound by base coating this all over it. So you just need to make sure you work this into all the little details, and you can still see some of that Chaos Black spray through this coat. So I'm going to let this coat dry and apply a second thin coat afterwards. And applying multiple thin coats like this always keeps the detail nice and sharp. Now on the Lord, I'm going to be doing exactly the same process on the upper part of his cloak. And I'm going to apply it in exactly the same way. I've finished applying the two thin coats of Khorne Red now, and you can see it's given a nice strong colour, and we're ready for the next part, which is to start painting in the areas that are going to be darker, so the pattern on the back of the Flesh Hound, and also the lower part of the cloak as well. For this I'm going to be using Eschen Grey, and I'm going to apply this using my medium base brush this time, because I want a bit more control, but I don't want to be too accurate with the pattern on the Flesh Hound, because I want to create quite a random feel to it. So once you've got your paint ready, you don't need a whole lot on your brush, all you got to do is start painting this down the back of the Flesh Hound. I'm going to start around the head here. What I'm going to do is quite roughly put it on like this, down to around the cheek there, so filling in the eye and going over the snout as well, about there. Now, as I get further down the body, I'm going to follow these little bumps that appear on it, so you can see there's a whole load of them down the side. I'll paint this this fan that comes up the back, and you can see these bumps, they kind of go down its leg as well, so I'm going to follow it as we get down there like that, still being quite rough. Then I'm going to skip to the ones just down there like that. So you just need to carry on doing this method all down its back. Now also, I'm going to be doing this colour over the claws and the teeth too. And you will need to apply two thin coats this colour to really build it up to a strong coat. And you apply it in the same way onto the cloak of the Lord as well on the lower part of it. Now that we've finished applying both of those colours, we're ready to add some shade. I'm going to be using Nuln Oil, and I'm actually going to be applying two coats to this because I want to really darken down these colours we've got so far. I'm going to apply this using my medium shade brush, and I'm going to get a good amount of this loaded on the palette. And, I'm going to be applying this to both these areas that we've been painting so far in the same way, but it's especially important on the Flesh Hound here because doing this is going to help blend the colours together. So all I'm going to do is just start applying this all over it, getting a good amount really worked into all the detail, as you can see I'm doing here. Not so much that it's pooling on the miniature, just so that I'm really starting to mark out all the little details and give them depth. And you apply this in exactly the same way on the Lord, and remember to give it plenty of time to dry. About half an hour should be fine. Once the first coat of Nuln Oil is completely dry, add a second coat in exactly the same way, so still working it into all the recesses. And doing this is going to darken these colours down even further and help break up this line between the Eschen Grey and the Khorne Red. The second coat of shade is now fully dry and we're ready to start brightening the colours back up again. And we're going to go to Khorne Red once again first. I'm going to reapply this, but differently this time, much more controlled, so I'm going to use my medium layer brush to do this. And what I'm looking to do here is to start bringing out all the definition of the muscle on the Flesh Hound and the folds in the cloak to make them, well, brighter. So thin your paint down with a little bit more water than normal, so you can for this kind of consistency, and make sure you don't have much on your brush, and just drag your brush along and twist it to bring the bristles to a nice tip. And what you're looking to do is to paint this over most of the area, but avoid the areas where the shade has settled. So on the flesh hound's hind leg here, what you want to do is look carefully for the areas where the shade is and just paint around those parts, avoiding the darker bits. So for example, I'm just going to be following these muscles around here. Now this first coat will look quite bright, but as it dries, it will settle down and it'll give you a really nice effect on the skin. So just take your time with this stage, working around gently, just avoiding any bits where there's more shade, and really build up the colour for the skin. Now that I've finished reapplying the corn red, you can see the red's much brighter once again. And on the cloak, notice how I've still done the same technique by avoiding the recessed parts, which generally follow the folds as they go down the cloak. And now what we're going to do is to highlight it. I'm going to start out with tusk or fur to do this, and I'm going to be using my small layer brush to apply it, because this is all about keeping the paint under as much control as possible. So I'm going to make sure I thin the paint down and just check on the palette that it's flowing nice and easily. And you don't want very much on your brush. Just get that nice fine tip. There we are. Perfect. So I'll start doing this in the Lord, and what I'm looking to do is essentially paint thin lines following all the sharper details of the folds. So for example, I've got this one down here. I'm just going to paint a line just running along that crease there like that. Now also you need to do around the actual edges of it as well, and in this case where it's more defined, you can actually just use the side of your brush like this and just gently run it along that edge, and that way you get a nice sharp line very easily like that. On the flesh hound, the technique is much the same. What you're looking to do is look for, once again, all sharper details. So if we go back to the hind leg that we were doing earlier, I'm looking for things like wrinkles. So I've got this one just running up here. I'll just pick that out there. And we've got another one along there. And then down the front of the leg like this. So you see, doing this is just starting to really bring out these features. So you just need to carry on doing this now over all the red parts that you've done so far. And with that highlight applied, the red is now finished, and we can do the same to the black parts. And the colour that we're going to use to do this highlight is Dawnstone. And the application is going to be much the same as what we just did for Tusk or Fur. So still with the small layer brush, make sure the paint's flowing really easily. So use your palette to do that. Add a little bit of water into the paint. And then just check your brush on the palette to make sure the paint is flowing easily and that you get a good fine point on your brush. And we'll start out with the Lord for this. I'm going to go around the edge of his cloak. And again, what you can do on these more pronounced parts is just use the edge of your brush very lightly to get a nice straight line like that around the edge. And also, you need to carry on these folds that appear in the cloak as well. So what I do is look for where the red highlight is and basically just carry this on down into the black parts as well using the same technique. There we go. Now for the flesh hound, we're going to be doing much the same thing again. So you're looking at just picking out all the sharper details on the black areas. So if we go up to the face here, we've got quite a few sharp lines around where the muzzle is. So you just need to follow them around like that. So we've got that one around there and just above the eye and so on. Also, we've got these little like bumps that go down into the back of its body. So for this, all I do is just very lightly just touch my brush to some of them like that, just to pick out some of these highlights. And also at this stage, you want to highlight the teeth and the claws as well. So once again, just paint a line down the sharpest part of them. Now that the highlight of Dawnstone has been added, the details on the black are standing out nicely. But there's just one more highlight that I want to do for the black, and this is going to be for the teeth and claws and the flesh hound only, just to make them look a little bit different from the rest of the black that we got on the model. Now I'm going to be using Carrick Stone to do this, and the application is just what we've just done, so still with a small layer brush, and making sure I don't have much paint on the brush and that it's flowing easily. All I'm going to do is paint this on the very tips of the teeth and claws. So if I start on the teeth up here, all I'm going to do is paint a small amount of this following the highlight I added previously, but just towards the end of the tooth, like that. And with that highlight of Carrick Stone added to the teeth and claws, the vast majority of the flesh hound is done. We've just got a few more details left to do on it, which we're going to do now. And we'll first of all paint the neck fan. And to do this, we just need three colours. First of all, we're going to base coat the membrane using Bugman's Glow. Then we're going to shade over it using Karaberg Crimson. And finally, we'll add a highlight using Cadian Flesh Tone. So starting out with a base coat of Bugman's Glow, I'm going to use my small base brush to apply this. And well, it's just a matter of getting a nice smooth base coat for this. So I'm going to thin my paint down with a little bit of water, get some loaded on the brush, and then just start painting this onto the membrane of the neck fan. So just be really careful as you put this on to avoid the red parts, and you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour. Once you've finished applying the base coat, switch to your medium shade brush to paint on Karaberg Crimson onto the membrane, and be careful not to put on too much at once so you can keep it under control, because you don't want to get this onto the red parts. Once the shade's fully dry, highlight the membrane with Cadian Flesh Tone by painting a line along the edge of it, along each of the creases in it, and also around any of the holes in it as well. And with that, the membrane is complete, and we can move on to the next details of the flesh hound, which are going to be the tongue and the eyes. Now, there is also the collar, but we're going to come back to that later on when we're painting the metallics. And starting out with the tongue, we're going to begin with a base coat of Screamer Pink, then we'll highlight it using Evilson Scarlet, then we'll turn our attention to the eyes, for which we just need Flash Gits Yellow. Now, starting out with Screamer Pink, I'm going to use my small layer brush for this because the tongue is quite small, so I want as much control over my paint as possible. So once you've got it ready, all you need to do is, as neatly as possible, just start applying this in the mouth. So just be really careful so that you don't get this colour on the teeth, and I do recommend applying two thin coats of this colour. Once the base coat's done, apply a highlight of Evilson Scarlet, and you don't need very much of this, just a small amount on the tip of the tongue. And finally, paint the eye with a small amount of Flash Gits Yellow. And to do this, just keep your hand as steady as possible and use a small brush. So I'm using my artificial brush for this. And all you need is to touch a small dot of yellow to the eye like that. And with those details painted, we can leave the flesh hound for now and start to concentrate on the Lord. And we're going to start out by painting his skin, because the skin's quite tricky to get to. So if we do it first, then it won't matter if we are actually a bit messy putting in the initial colours on it, because we'll neaten up as we add further base colours to the miniature. Now, the first colour we're going to use is Rakarth Flesh, and this I'm going to apply using my small base brush. And for this early step, all I'm looking to do is to get a good solid base coat on the skin. So once you've got your paint ready, a little bit of water mixed in, all I'm going to do is start applying this to the flesh. And there's little parts of his face you can see, and also the belly down here, which is where I'm going to start. So you can see I can be quite messy with this. It doesn't matter if I make any mistakes, because as I say, we'll neaten up as we go. But just make sure you get a nice solid coverage, so I'll recommend two thin coats. With the base coat applied, we're now ready to put on the first layer, and the colour for this is Flayed One Flesh. And this paint I'm going to be applying using my medium layer brush, and the application here is going to be just the same as what we've just done, a nice smooth coat over all the areas for the skin. So once I've got my paint ready, all I'm going to do is start applying this onto all the areas of flesh, once again not being very neat because the skin's the only part that matters here, and again I recommend applying two thin coats. With the skin now layered with Flayed One Flesh, we're ready to add some shade. And the shade I'm going to use is Reichland Flesh Shade. I'm going to apply it using my medium shade brush, because we don't want loads of this, just enough to cover the areas of skin that we've painted in so far. So once you've got some ready on your palette, just load up your brush and start painting this onto the flesh. And make sure you get enough on there so that it settles nicely in the recesses, like we're getting here, but not so much that it's pooling anywhere. And once you've applied it, give it plenty of time to dry. About 20 minutes will be fine. The Reichland Flesh Shade is now fully dry, and we're going to leave the flesh actually for the time being and start adding some of the base colours to the model. We will come back to the flesh later on, but for now what we're going to do is start out by painting Balthazar Gold on all the parts that are going to be brass. So this will be things like the cornate icons and also all the trim on the armour, and of course the collar on the flesh hound. Then we're going to move on to using Corn Red to paint the actual main colour of the armour plates. After that, we'll use Mournfang Brown to paint the grip of the axe, so all the leather parts like that. Once that's finished, we're going to use Abaddon Black to paint any tassel decorations on the Lord. And then we'll be using Lead Belcher to paint the actual blade of the axe and also chains. And finally, we'll use Zandri Dust to paint all the bone parts. But starting out with Balthazar Gold, I'm going to use my small base brush to apply this. And at this stage, all you're looking to do is to base coat all the parts that you want to be brass. And we only really need to be neat around the parts we've finished so far. So just be careful whenever you're near the skin and the cloak as well. But otherwise, it can be fairly messy as you apply this. So just make sure you get all these parts that you want to be the brass colour. Once you've finished applying all of the Balthazar Gold, the next colour to use is Corn Red to paint in the actual red armour panels. Now, I've switched to a medium layer brush to do this for maximum control, and you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour. Next, base coat the grip of the axe with Mournfang Brown, and again, apply two thin coats. With the two thin coats of Mournfang Brown applied, the next colour to use is Abaddon Black for the little tassel that we've got hanging from the icon here, and also the cords of the little trinkets that are also hanging from this icon. The next base colour to apply is Lead Belcher. Now this of course is for the axe blade, but also for all the chains and the chainmail as well. And finally, base coat all the bone parts using Zandri dust. And I really do recommend once again that you apply two thin coats of this colour and be as neat as you can with it, particularly around the face. With those base colours applied, we're now ready to put some shade onto them. I'm going to use Agrax Earth Shade for this, using the medium shade brush because I want to keep this under as much control as possible. You don't want to be painting this all over the miniature, just on these newer base colours that we've added. So once you've got some paint ready, get some on your brush, and I'm just going to start applying this, starting down on the leg here, I think. Now, when you're doing this, the trick is just to make sure you don't put on too much, so that you don't get it onto any of the other colours that we've already done so far. So you're only looking at putting it on these newer base colours. So whenever you get close to the other colours, such as the skin around here, just be really careful that you don't get it onto those. And remember to paint this onto the Fleshhound's collar as well, and do it in exactly the same way. The Agrax Earthshade is now fully dry, and you can see it's settled nicely in all the recesses and really helped define them. But the colours now are dulled down a bit, and we need to brighten them up in preparation for the highlighting. And we need to do the same for the skin as well, which if you remember earlier, we did apply some shade to as well. Now we're going to start by reapplying Corn Red to all of the red armour plates. Then after that, we'll reapply Flayed on Flesh to all of the skin. Then finally, we're going to do a layer of a Shabti bone on all the bone parts to brighten those bits up as well. But starting with Corn Red, using my medium layer brush this time, and I do have my small layer brush on hand just in case, because some of these details are quite small, so I can switch that brush if I need to for a bit more control. But what I'm going to do is get my paint so it's flowing smoothly on the palette with some water, and twist my brush to a nice point. And what I'm going to do is start reapplying this to the red, but this time I'm going to avoid the recessed parts where the shade settled earlier on. So around here, for example, you can see the shade settled in between the brass and the red, and by just avoiding that deepest area there and painting in the flatter areas, I'm making the colour a bit brighter and keeping that nice shading. So what you need to do now is carry on doing this over all of the red panels. Next, layer Flayed One Flesh once again over the skin, following exactly the same technique. So look out for where the shade is thickest and just avoid those areas. And finally, layer all the bone parts using a Shabti bone, once again avoiding all the areas where the shade has settled the most. And you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour. And there we go, with those colours brightened up, we're now ready to start adding some highlights. And we're going to begin by highlighting all the metallic parts, so all the brass and the silver bits, using Runefang Steel. Once we've done that, we're going to use Evil Sun Scarlet to highlight all the red armour panels, and then we'll use Eshin Grey to highlight the black, of which there isn't much. But once we've done that, we'll use Pallid Witch Flesh to highlight all the skin and the bone at the same time. But starting with Runefang Steel, I'm going to use my small layer brush for this, and I'm going to stick to this brush through this whole process. I need to make sure I use the palette to be sure that the paint's flowing smoothly, which is very important for this stage, and make sure there's not too much on your brush either. Then what you want to do is start painting this along all the sharper edges. So highlighting here is much like when we were highlighting the Fleshhound earlier on. If I start with this skull on here, what I'm going to do is look for details like the brow along there. Then we've got some of these lines that run up down towards the back of the skull. And it just progresses onto the horn, of which we've got these ridges going along here. And you can see I'm just looking for all these sharper edges, and I'm just picking them out by using fine lines as neatly as I can. Now also, we need to highlight the chainmail as well, and there is some hanging from here, and to do this, all you've got to do is just very lightly run your brush down it like that. Once you've finished highlighting with Runefang Steel, do the same in all the red panels using Evil Sun Scarlet. Now that the red's done, the next colour to highlight is the black, and that's with Eshin Grey, and really just looking at these little tassels and cords up on the icon. And finally, highlight the bone and the skin using Pallid Witch Flesh. And once again, you're looking for sharper details, such as on here on this skull. I'm going to go across the brow, just around the eye as well, and on the cheekbone, and then across the top of the nose. So all areas like that, you see as I'm bringing out the features. And the same is true on the skin. So on the belly here, I'm looking for the edges of things, such as these little holes we've got in his belly. I've now finished applying those highlights, and notice as well I've also highlighted the Fleshhound's collar. And with that done, there's just a couple more details left to do. And the first of these we're going to concentrate on is the claw arm that's holding the axe. And also at the same time we're going to be painting the teeth that go around the collar and waist of the armour, because these are painted using the same colours. And you only need four colours to do this. We're going to start first of all by using a base coat of Rhinox Hide, and then we're going to shade over this using Norn Oil. After that we're going to start highlighting first of all with Gorthor Brown, and then a very fine highlight of Carrack Stone. We're starting out with a base coat of of Rhinox hide. I'm going to use my small base brush to apply it. And really, for this step, all you want is a nice solid base coat over all the areas that are going to be this color. So I'm going to start on the claw arm, just around here. And as you're doing this, just be really careful as you go around the claws where it's holding the axe. After you've applied the base coat, add a shade of Nuln Oil all over the Rhinox hide. Now I'm using a medium shade brush on the claw, but you might want to switch down to a smaller brush, like a small layer brush, when applying it on the teeth and the armour, just to keep it under control. Once the shade's fully dry, highlight these areas with Gorthor Brown by just picking out some of the sharper details. And finally, finish these areas with a small highlight of Carrick Stone just on the very sharpest parts, such as these little bits in the claw on the back here. Also the tips of the teeth, and I'm going to be highlighting the grip of the axe using this colour as well by just painting it along all the sharper parts of it. And with the claw, teeth and axe grip done, there's now just one more detail left to paint on the miniature. And that's on the back of it, on the cloak we've got up here, this kind of circular design that goes over the red part. And that's what we're going to do now, with a kind of gold-like appearance to it. And the first colour that we want for this is XV88. Now this is just going to be our standard base colour application. So using your small base brush, make sure you've got your paint ready on your palette. And then once you're happy with the amount of paint in your brush, and again you don't need too much, just start applying this onto this area. Now just be as neat as you can because of that red on there. You don't want to get any of this colour on the red, but you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour. Once you finish the base coat, the next thing to do is to shade the symbol, and I'm going to be using Agrax Earthshade to do this with my medium shade brush. And remember, with this stage, you don't want to put on loads of this, you just want enough that it settles in the recesses of the folds on the pattern. So once you've got some on your palette, use that to control exactly how much is on your brush, and then just start painting it onto the symbol. And what you want to do is to have this settling in the folds of it, so such as just along there, for example, and then just gently paint it across the whole surface, and again, it will settle more where the folds are. The shade's now fully dry and settled in the recesses nicely, and what we need to do now is start brightening the pan up again in preparation for the highlight. So we're going back to XV88 first of all, and I'm going to be applying this in a slightly unusual way. First of all, I'm going to get some paint ready in the same kind of fashion, using my small layer brush for this. Thin it down as usual, and so you've got normal kind of consistency. Get that fine tip on your brush. And then what you do is start out by continuing the highlights that we've got on the cloak. So you can see we've got these highlight lines running down it. What I'm going to do is start out by using XV88 to follow that highlight all the way down. So you can see I'm just filling it in really, like that. And then what you do is go back to your paint and thin it down much more on your palette. So you want quite a watery consistency now. So you can see how much thinner I'm making it here. And then really make sure you don't have very much of this on your brush. So I'm going to use that to get rid of the excess. And what you can do, in fact, if you're not sure, you can always use your hand just to test how much you've got on your brush. And I do have too much there, so I can get rid of the excess there. And there we go. And what I'm going to do is start with these lines that we've got and basically apply a very thin coat going towards the darker shade like that. So you can see I'm getting a nice transition between the stronger line there, and then it gradually fades away as we get to the recess. With the XV88 now reapplied, we're ready to add some highlights. And we're going to start off, first of all, by highlighting with a Shapti bone using a small airbrush once again. And we'll begin by following the pattern of the cloak when we're highlighting it earlier on. So once you've got that fine tip on your brush, the first thing to look for are those lines. So for example, we've got these ones down here, and I'm just going to start out by painting my highlight, just following them along like that there. Now also, I'm going to be highlighting along the top and bottom of the pattern, but I'm not going to go all the way. Wherever the deeper recesses are where the shade is settled, I'm just going to leave those parts. So for example, on this bit here, I'm just going to be highlighting about that far back. And with your Shapti bone applied, there's just one more colour left to go to finish the effect, and that colour is Pallid Witch Flesh. And this is just a fine highlight just to finish it off, so make sure you get that really good tip on your brush. So use the palette once again to do that. And when you're ready, all you need to do is to paint this on the sharper creases of the cloak. So the areas that we were starting with earlier on, just these little ones like here, you need to paint a line down each of these. And with that, the effect will be finished. And all that remains then is to glue on the flesh hound to the miniature. And I recommend you do that using super glue thin. And after that, you just got to base it. And as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. And with the base complete, Corgus Cole, the mighty Lord of Khorne, is now finished and ready to lead his legions to victory over the Stormcast Eternal. So always remember, when you're painting more complex miniatures like this, it's always a good idea to think about sub-assemblies before you start painting anything, because as you've seen, sub-assemblies can make the painting much easier and able to get to all those details that otherwise would be really hard to paint. Now, with characters, there's often a lot more detail than on regular troopers, so always make sure that you use a palette to control how much paint is on your brush, and also to allow you to thin the paint down as well. And when you apply the paint to the model, always apply it as multiple thin coats and gradually build up the colour, because doing this keeps the detail nice and sharp, whereas one thick coat of paint can really make all that detail become quite lumpy and hidden. And finally, when we applied shade to this miniature, there were lots of times when we had to be really careful about how we applied it. So always remember to only apply as much as you need, keep it under control, and always pick an appropriate brush to apply it as well. So we've come to the end of the series, and well, we really hope that you've enjoyed it and learned loads of cool things about painting your miniatures. Have fun painting them, and we'll see you again soon.